condolences for not coming in the top three. I am gobsmacked.
It's okay.
I really thought you were coming in top three. You were robbed.
Oh,
you were just, you looked absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
Fabulous. Oh, I could run out of just, wow, too many amazing words to say about you. Have you had a lovely day?
Yeah, back again tomorrow.
Oh, cool. Are you at the after party tonight?
No, I'm not.
Who's going to the after party tonight?
I don't know.
I need to crash DJ set. Rickroll the entire hall.
Yeah.
Yeah, play usual mix of cheesy pop, big club anthems, hard rock, proper hip-hop, not the ones here today, and a bit of everything really, and nostalgic hits, because I am pretty much a big music wizard. I know a lot about music and films because I'm a pop culture junkie, so you're going to put my brain to the test, because I usually do these at conventions. When was your birthday?
March the 16th.
In what year?
2003.
March 16th, 2003. So you're 16 years old.
Yeah, I am.
Wow.
People don't seem to think that, but yeah.
You're 16. Gee, that's amazing. So, right, what was number one? March. What date was it?
The 16th.
March 16th. I thought it was 16th. Was not March 16th, 2003. I should know this. Gonna take a wild guess and say tattoo all the things she said. I think I'm wrong, but that's my guess. We'll go for another guess. Happiness. No, is it? No, Loneliness by Tom Craft. Look it up when I get home, because my last GeekFest vlog, I did it to Hilda from The Legend of Zelda, and I was correct. She said it was February something, 1998, and it was Celine Dion, My Heart Will Go On, and I was right. So I'll get home and see if I'm right, March 16th, 2003. I don't think it's tattoo, but my final guess would be Tom Craft, Loneliness. You've heard that song?
I have.
Happiness seems to be loneliness. There's a quality tune. Nostalgia. I think looking back at the noughties, I think we took that decade for granted. There were a lot of good things. Even some things were not that great, you know, with the Iraq War, War on Terror. There's still plenty of good music, films, a lot of good stuff on the telly as well. Do you remember, I think you were too young to remember, Balls of Steel?
No.
Right, look it up on YouTube. It is hilarious.
Okay.
It's like they do these crazy pranks in public. Next Urban Sports is the best, because he does swear bingo, knock and don't run. You knock on someone's door and say, this is my door, and there was this big woman, she got really pissed with him. He's like, this is my door, no, this is my door.
Do what you want, I don't care, just please.
I'm taking the piss.
You're knocking on my door, my door.
My door.
My door. Stop knocking on my door. What's wrong with you?
My flat. So funny. But I mean, I'll see you tomorrow. It's awesome seeing you. It's lovely to meet you.
You too.
Yeah. Bye. Hello, it's yours truly. I'm here at the after party. Different location, like last year. It seems to be a recurring theme at GeekFest that certain points of the whole event, they always change location every year. So it's past 7 o'clock. And the after party, a big lineup. I doubt if I'll be allowed to film any of it, but there's the dark room, which should be very interesting from what I've heard. There's also going to be a geek quiz. I think me and Bill might team up together if there's pairs for the geek quiz. Apparently the after party runs very late this year, probably till 3 in the morning, but I'm planning to go before midnight. Sadly, the Lionesses lost their third place match to Sweden 2-1, but the Lionesses, I'm still so proud of them. Reaching the semi-finals, second Women's World Cup running. Also, Joanna Konta is into the fourth round of Wimbledon. Hear that, Bill? Joanna Conta won.
Ah, sweet.
Yeah, and she's playing Petra Kvitova on Monday.
Ooh, bad luck.
Manic, yeah, this Monday, Manic Monday on Wimbledon.
Yeah.
It's where all the players play together.
Yes. Yep, and obviously Serena's through. She's facing Carlos Suarez. Something.
Carlos Suarez Navarro.
Yep.
I believe.
Just having a look at what her best performance has been.
Fleetwood Mac playing in there.
Yep.
This is Bill doing the bottle cap challenge.
Come on.
Come on, do it again. One more try. Is it that hard to do? Is it really that hard to do?
What the hell, maybe? Who makes these challenges?
And how do they get so trendy? It's beyond me.
Ice bucket challenge. Mannequin challenge. Guy walking.
Do you remember planking?
Oh, yeah. I still get it. I mean. No.
Oh. Yay! You did it! Well, not the right way, but still, you done it.
Yep, Emma Watson.
You sure it's Emma Watson?
I'm sure.
Probably I'm not used to seeing her with the hair tied back.
Yeah. That's Alan Rickman.
Hans Gruber.
Hello, no.
Let me see.
Number 8.
I feel like I recognise her. Number 9, by the way, yeah. Video game character, it's Cloud Strife.
Yes.
Cloud.
Yeah.
And you spell his surname. S-T-R-I-F-E.
And number 10, another meeting.
Alright, the Geek Quiz is about to start. I wouldn't be feeling much of it, but the best of luck to Bill and I.
Number 5, which order brought about the death of the Jedi?
It's the year England won the World
Cup. Number 6. So, question number 6. There are some of you that will feel compelled to raise your hand and make a stink about this question.
Me?
I would very much suggest that you stay quiet because it will help you to answer it. I can tell, as soon as I ask this, you two will be like, oh, sir. And I would don't, because you'll give away the answer.
Okay.
So, in which film does Darth Vader say, Luke, I am your father?
Bias choice. Easy.
Oh, go on then. Now, those of you that felt the need to speak up then, I feel like you might understand what I'm getting. Number 7. What does AT-AT stand for?
Oh!
What does AT-AT stand for?
Oh, God. AT-AT.
Is that from Star Wars?
Yeah.
Don't.
Question 3. Who is going to stop blowing on my shit?
Not funny.
It wasn't a swear word, it was a decision.
Whatever.
I'm not quite sure.
Yes.
Question number 8. Which actor has appeared in the most MCU films? When I say MCU, I mean Marvel Cinematic Universe.
I'm going to make a guess.
I would have gone for Samuel Jackson. We'll see.
And question number 10. What was the name of the character?
One second.
Silent judgment.
7 seconds away.
Yes, Gary, what that was. Number 7. Number 8. And again, this is another one you're not going to get much of.
Again, my love life.
Shut up.
No, don't mind.
Jack,
they're
not been you.
That's it. No more. Number 9.
You said he'd be very impressed if anyone gets this, so right. You're on the cards there.
And he was voiced by David Hayter.
Yeah.
Hmm. I've heard of that name before.
Was Miley Cyrus, most famous for playing Hannah Montana. Question 3 was Brian Blessed. That's a terrible pronunciation. And was the voice of Boss Nass. Question number 4 was Gwendolyn Christie. And her full title at the end of her TV show was Sir Brienne of Tarth.
Oh, it was Game of Thrones.
Question 5 was Peter Serafinovich. And again, be generous with the spelling on that one. And he was the voice of Darth Maul. Question number 6 was Emma Watson. And according to her most popular character, what was worse than being killed was being expelled.
I was expelled from school.
Question 7 was Alan Rickman. And his first major acting role was as Hans Gruber.
Woo! I knew that!
If someone wrote Die Hard, you would have half a point. Right. Number 8, the actor was Billy Lord.
Billy Lord?
Yeah.
And she was in Star Wars The Force Awakens.
Billy Lord, Carrie Fisher's daughter.
Question number 9 was Cloud Strife, and he is the former member of the elite military group known as Soldier.
Oh, that's it! I was trying to remember. Soldier. Step by step, heart to heart, left, right, left, all fall down like toy soldiers.
Number 10 was Amelia Clark. Was the ending of her TV show any good? Yes.
What?
Yes, it was. You're all watching the wrong show if you didn't think it was.
You what, mate?
Moving on. 8.
Yes, I got that right. 8. I think we did good in the first round.
What character became the third best known figure for young boys after Michael Jordan and Arnold Schwarzenegger in the US? It was Sonic the Hedgehog.
Oh!
Damn it!
Mario and Sonic were running in my head, and Mario got it. Oh!
I'm as surprised as all of you. I mean, not really, I knew this like 3 days ago when I wrote this. Number three, the highest selling home console of all time was the PlayStation 2.
I got that. Woo!
Number four, the games console that was first to come equipped with a modem was the Dreamcast.
Yay! Most underrated games console ever.
Question five. In the original game, how many polygons made up Lara Croft? 350.
Oh!
So if you had
well off that
320 and 380, you get the point. And if you're at all interested, the most recent one had about 20,000 and something. How many power stars can you collect in Super Mario 64? 120.
Yay! I finally got them all just 2 months ago.
The four playable characters in Resident Evil 2. There is a point for each one of these. Claire Redfield, Leon S. Kennedy, Hunk, and Tofu Saliva.
Oh.
So in this argument that there's another two, if you add the other two...
Sherry and Ada! Sherry!
Ada!
Sherry! Sherry, baby, Sherry!
I'm referring all to rule number one. So, number eight. What was the biggest selling video game in the 90s? It was Tetris.
What?
Tetris?
Wasn't that released in 89?
It wasn't on, it was the Game Boy.
How
many copies did it sell? 26.5 million.
Woof!
Number one. At 14 years old, who is the youngest Disney princess? Forever ruining your memory of this film, Snow White.
Ah. Snow White.
That's right, everyone. Snow White was 14 when that film was on.
Snow White, God.
Bill's face, real puzzled.
Snow White is 14.
14. A year younger than Coco Gauff.
How old is the bloody prince?
Oh my God.
And his friendship with the dragon. Pete's dragon. There were questions of other.
You put Pete and the dragon. Yeah, we'll accept that.
Number three. When Big Max is low on battery, how does he act? Yeah, so you can have drunk is one answer. Silly or stupid is an auto acceptable answer. Sleepy. Sleepy's fine. Slow. Yes, no slow. There's a whole collection of adjectives you could use. Number five, which order brought about the death of the Jedi? Order 66.
Whoa! It's number four!
Sorry, that was five.
Oh!
That's five, I meant to do it that way. Number four,
everyone makes 66,
better known as Stitch. Question number six. In which film does Darth Vader say, Luke, I am your father? None of them. It's a most commonly misquoted. Trick question. Question five was which order brought back Death of the Jedi, and that was Order 66. Number seven, what does AT-AT stand for? All terrain armored transport. Question number eight. Which actor has appeared in the most MCU films? Stan Lee.
Going around. We should have got that!
Why? For those of you that are furious and think I'm wrong, I refer you to rule number one. Number nine. In the MCU, what does SHIELD stand for? Stands for Strategic Homeland Intervention Enforcement and Logistics Division.
Who got that right? Oh, Richard did.
The character hired to play the Mandarin in Iron Man 3, Trevor Slattery. Got time to go through all the music again. Okay. It's really, really running behind. Number one was Futurama.
Oh.
Number two was Angel.
Yeah.
Number three was 1 point for Star Trek. One more point for Star Trek, Deep Space Nine.
Yay! Well done, Phil.
Number four was Red Dwarf.
Number five,
anyone get that?
Well, duh.
Number seven was Pokemon.
Duh. Gotta catch 'em all.
Number eight was Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Yeah.
Number nine was The X-Files.
Woo.
And number 10 was... Well, I wanted to be in the Teenage Mutant. Well done, everyone, about that.
That's what TARDIS stands for.
Yeah.
Time and relative dimension in space.
Right, round number five, question number one. What does TARDIS stand for? Time and relative dimension in space. Number two, and you have to have all of those words correct in the right order. You were wrong. Sure. It's the only fair thing to do. Number two. Which actor and Doctor Who companion reached number 10 in the album charts in 2016? Bradley Walsh.
Yay! With backing vocals from Fanny Schmeller.
Well, don't bother listening. Number three, what were the last words of the 10th Doctor? I don't want to know. Number four, what planet are the Selene from? Again, thank you. Feel free to be generous with saying that I can't imagine. If there's a lot of vowels, then probably right. Question number five. Which queen did the 10th Doctor marry? Queen Elizabeth the First. Question number six. Which one of the Doctor's hands got cut off? It was the right hand. Question number seven. What do German Daleks say? They say, exterminate them.
Ah.
It's German Dalek impression. Exterminieren. Yes. Number eight. In episode closed, what is exactly is controlling the autons? It is the nesting consciousness. Again, spelling would be very nice. Number nine. What is the name of the girl in the fireplace? Madame de Pompadour. Number 10, what alias does the Doctor often use when going undercover as a human? It is John Smith. Last 10 questions. The first episode of Doctor Who Today was shown in which year in the USA? 1997.
Yay! Also the last year.
Oh, wait, no. Which actor has appeared in the most Batman movies? Christian Bale. Number three, what are the similarities between Cookie Monster, Yoda, and Miss Piggy? They are all voiced by the same person.
Frank Oz!
Frank Oz.
Woo!
Number four, which Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle always wears a red bandana? It is Raphael. Number five, who said the only time a man can be brave is when he's afraid? That was Ned Stark. Question number six. 3 points for this one if you get them in the right order. The three items are Arnold Schwarzenegger requests in Terminator 2. Your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle. Number seven. In 1987, what took over from the Flintstones as the longest running primetime animated series was The Simpsons.
Well, duh.
Number eight. The name of Mila Jovovich's character in The Fifth Element was Lilu.
Woo! Lilu Dallas Multipass.
No extra points because no one likes to talk to us. But you can go home and accept the knowledge that you do move on. Number nine. Which TV comedy series follows the employees at the fictional Sacred Heart Teaching Hospital, Trust?
Yay! Better than Friends.
Number 10, finally. Has everyone got the answers? Do anyone need anything repeated before I start? Alfred, it's not an actor. We'll come to that one in a minute. What was the speed below which the bomb would explode in speed? 50 miles an hour. So, count them all up, put the total score in, bring them down.
Wow, that quiz was really fun. Me and Bill thoroughly enjoyed it, and some of the correct answers we heard were unexpected as they turned out to be trick questions. I knew most of the questions, and it was so really cool. And I... Bill is counting up our contestants next to us. Could not believe, Phil, how shocked were you to find out Snow White is 14?
Yeah.
Wow.
Woo!
That's indigenous.
Yeah, there we go. I think most of the Disney princesses in the early days are a bit... Okay.
I think Rolf Harris would be fans of the early Disney films. Oh! I have such a dark sense of humour.
Nobody said anything.
Our next entertainment for tonight is the Dark Room. I will not... No, it's a real video game, apparently. But we will not be filming any of this. Just enjoy the experience ourselves without filming. So, yeah. Oh, my God. That was hugely unexpected. Shocking. I did not brace myself for what the Dark Room, the live-action video game, would be like. It is a brutal roasting session from a very hyperactive potty-mouthed Australian, and he's back here again tomorrow. I have to, with kids in the audience. I think he'll make it PG-rated. Well, I'm not sure, but oh my God. If you are over 18, the Dark Room is highly recommended. It is just, I found myself very engaged towards the end. It was that brilliant, hysterical, and just, I love the humour as well, and the political humour. It was just excellent. So, the Dark Room, go see it. If it's anywhere near town, that was a fantastic treat. Oh my God, and I've lost my voice as well. Mario Brothers wearing some fancy necklaces here, whatever they are.
Pills.
What about you, Jack Sparrow? You already got roasted. You were brutally roasted in that dark room. That was amazing.
And I will literally leave you to this, all right? One sentence. You may kill me, but you may never insult me.
Oh, really?
I don't know why I'm in fact who? Who am I? Captain Jack Sparrow.
And thank you. Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yuya.
Party!
people get wary. Not very pretty, I tell you. Walking in town is quite scary. Not very sensible either. The friend of a friend who got beaten. You look the one way to the policeman. You're not gonna have to speak. I love you and
party ever. It's 11:30. I just texted mum for her to pick me up, and Dave and the first day GeekFest 5.0 now coming to a close. I had a pint of beer, a pint of lager. I'm not drunk. Basically awesome after party, brilliant fun geek quiz, a frantic, hysterical, shocking live action video game from the dark room. Oh my god, I'm so glad I didn't get roasted. But it has been a wonderful after party. Not wonderful, that's too. It's been a frantic after party for sure. And it's time for me to go home, get some sleep, charge this Xperia battery up. And it's truly been a I should stay in the light because it's very dark. Yeah, my mum just texted me. You just heard the beep beep sound. So, Jack Walker, yours truly, peace out.